de la domnul Goncear la catedră, Peridielco, da. Corect. Și puteam să închidi săptămâna asta, așa, amețetă tare.
Dar tezele de licență, gata, s-au susținut?
Gata, s-au terminat toate tezele de licență, da. Toate, 14, 16, nu știu câte au fost.
Și care media? La note? 9
au fost 9-10. Au fost 9-10. S-au pregătit băieți tare bine. Încă mai bine decât la cele preventive. Știi că avem preventive și apoi în finale. M-am mers la final că acum trebuie să meargă fără repetiție. Cred că au făcut ei repetiția necesară, dar s-au prezentat foarte bine. Și erau pregătiți foarte bine la răspunsuri. Deci se vede că materialul este lucrat bine, știi, așa, din adânc. De aceea îmi pare că un student de alții au fost cu 8.5, restul toți au fost cu 9.5 și 5 și 10. Așa. Bun. Eu cred că pentru ziua de astăzi e de ajuns.
Bine, nu mai apar. Succes.
Da. Mulțumim. Good afternoon, dear student. Not wait other student because it's necessary to keep our time. Da? And today will be not big, but is a very important topic, clinical pharmacology of diuretics, plasma volume substituents, and acid-base balance, regulating and hydroelectrolytics drugs the same. I not speak about the importance of OCHA. It's enough speak about the distributions intracellular approximately 40%, extracellular 20%, intravascular, interstitial, and you can see the same intravascular 5%, interstitial 15%, and 2-4% for different juice, gastric, intestinal, bile, cerebrospinal, and other type. You can see here. Sorry, I want to be sure you listen me good.
Yes.
Good. Thank you. what is the importance between electrolytes and colloids? Da? Be attentive because electrolytes diffuse across sectors and contribute to the maintenance of permanent ions gradient. Colloids, which not penetrate through the wall of capillary, but determine the direction, speed, and amount of ions diffusion. Crystalloid solution include salines and non-salt solution. Salines, isotonic, hypotonic, and hypertonic, you know, isotonic can be single isotonic solution like contain 0.9 sodium chloride. And polyelectrolytes, like example, Ringer, Ringer lactate, Ringer log, acesol, trisol, disol, another type of solution. Hypotonic, which contain only single solution 0.45% sodium chloride, and can be the same polyelectrolytes like ionosteryl HD5 or HF10. And hypertonic solution of chloride, sodium chloride solution can be 5, 10, or 20%, depends by the situation. And non-salts solutions like hypotonic, da, is 5%, and the same can be 10, 20, and 40. Can be in 30 if you need. You can obtain from chemistry if you prescribe 30%. Can be in some country in 30. Colloids that contain dextrans with low molecular weight, like be attentive, the low molecular weight contain or have a prefix neo, neopolyvidone, neomacrodex. Neo show about low molecular weight. Middle molecular weight, this is dextran 40, usually have prefix reo, reo macrodex, reo polyvidone, reo polyglucine. Reo show about middle molecular weight. And high molecular weight do not have some prefix, da? Only macrodex, polyglucin without some prefix. And the starch like hydroxyethylamidone, the polypeptide polymers like polygelin, oxypolygelatin or gelatin polysuccinate, and blood drugs like human albumin and plasma. According to the effects of drugs, all this solution divide according to the clinical importance. And the first type of classifications according to the importance, clinical effects more, which manifested, is hemodynamic type. Hemodynamic type or the drugs which good improve hemodynamic. This is the dextrans 40 and 70. You can see here yellow is not. Hydroxyethylamidone, polygeline, polyethylene glycol, and salines, the drugs which manifest and improve hemodynamics. Detoxifying type, you can see here, is low molecular weight of dextrans. Characteristic for this is detoxications in the body, therefore, and type of clinical is detoxifying type. Neocompensan, neopolibidon, interoides, and polydes. All this is low molecular weight of colloids. The set group, you can see the regulators of salines fluid balance and acid base, like solution salines. Sometimes ago we speak about this. Correctors fluid and electrolytes balance and acid base status the same, like lactosol, Hartmann solution, Ringer lactate, saline assembly is log, lactate show about influence on acid-base status. The same sodium hydrogen carbonate and trometamol, especially if is acidosis, to improve acidosis. Endosmotic diuretics, the same like mannitol and sorbitol. And drugs for parenteral nutrition. This is amino acid solution. You can see like polyamines, like vamine, aminosteril, Ka 10%, protein hydrolysate, like hydrolysin, amygen, another type of protein hydrolysates, and lipid emulsions. You can see the name contain and information about this intralipid, lipovenous, venolipid. And the same, the next is alcohols and carbohydrates, like glucose, fructose, was one type 20, more than 30 years ago. Alcohols used intravenously for nutrition, for like an energetic solution. But approximately 30 years not used because we have enough other possibility use other solution. The next group is oxygen carriers. Emulsions, fluorocarbonates, perforan, and hemoglobin solution which contain. Solutions, the next group is antihypoxant, the solution which contain salts like fumarate, succinate. This speak about the antihypoxant effects the same. And this complex action, because today you can see some drugs manifest complex action, 2, 3, not only one. Now we discuss about the advantages of crystalloids, like for colloids later, and the disadvantages the same. Advantages of crystalloids, you can see using all type in therapy of acute bleeding, have inoffensivity, have and low price. This is permit use all time in all country without some problem. Disadvantages, duration of action is short. Why is short? You can see after 1 hour, one hour approximately 80% from solution go in interstitial space. And therefore, you not maintain your aim, that, and therefore you need the next administration, other volume to maintain blood pressure or volume. Therefore, it's clear very often it's necessary to use the next doses, the next administration to keep blood volume. What this administration often contributes to develop edema, because all go to in this interstitial space. The next disadvantages when we use rapidly infusion and big volumes, very often associated with hypercoagulations due to this balance between pro and anticoagulants mechanism. And all this lead to physiological anticoagulants deficit. And the next disadvantages is especially characteristic for sodium chloride. It's clear for salines, because they can produce hyperchloremic acidosis. And therefore, these salines, according to the disadvantages, which is the modern advantages, it's necessary to associate with colloids to avoid these side or negative moments, side effects or disadvantages. Non-saline solutions like glucose, which is characteristic for glucose solutions, da? It's clear their aim is to improve hemodilutions, detoxifications, and use for correction of dehydration. Why this effect is manifested? After you use intravenously, glucose diffuses rapidly from the vascular bed in the same, in some minutes you can see, in tissue, in cell, and the rheological effects is the same, is not good, is insignificant. And like detoxifications, we can speak like effective drugs. Why? And here you can see glucose into hepatocytes is converted to glucuronic acid and can combine coupling different toxins like endogenous, exogenous, and other type. The same activates liver and other detoxifications mechanism, increase the glycogen storage, increase the oxidation reduction process, increase diuresis, and serves like energy source. You can see here, after administration of a glucose solution, approximately in bed remain only 7%. That's all. About 20-30% go in interstitial space. And intracellular go 65%. This is two parts, two set parts from administrated volume. Like volume effects, it's clear, is very weak because remain like in the other salines, only salines 20%, here remain only 7%, other go intracellular, interstitial, but not keep the volume. they are, because they go to the intracellular, that is more arguments why use glucose to correct intracellular dehydration between 60-70% of this glucose go to the go intracellular. And it's clear, attract, and water. It's necessary to remember if you use glucose, you can use in 4, 5, and 10%. And it's necessary to correct with insulin. This is must be in brain all time correction. is not recommended to use isotonic solution in cerebral circulation disorders because they can intensify the brain acidosis. Hypertonic solutions, it's clear, is shown is pathological conditions with increased catabolism or can use in incoercible vomiting, like osmotic diuretics, in case the of hyperkalemia, and for dehydration, cerebral edema. About what depend volume effects of plasma substitutes depends or determined by the coupling force of the water, which is proportional to the concentration of the colloids and opposite proportional to the molecular weight of the colloid. And the same depends the duration of persistent intravascular and the half-life. If we speak about the dextrans 40 and 70, they having viscosity and osmotic pressure similar to the plasma. You can see origin of obtained dextrans polysaccharides. This is answer. Later we speak about this, why appear allergic reaction, polysaccharides, origin of obtained dextrans. And now continue on the characteristic of dextrans 40 and 70. You can see here, not speak about the low molecular weight. About this we speak later because it's absolutely different if compare these three groups. Therefore, now about dextrans 40 and 70. Effects is very good volume.
Doctor,
effects. Yes.
Can you accept students?
I can't. I can't because my colleague make link and only he can accept. I can't. Therefore,
when he come back. When will you come back?
How many students is?
2, 3 around.
Now I try to call, but in the future, please be in time. 10 minutes, doctor, include because this is his technical problems. I can't, and therefore I ask him to include the student, and after he go. And not accept more, not destroy our activity. If he answers, if he answers, if not, I call him now. But he not answer. Doctor, te rog, mai accept vreo 2-3 studenți prăpădiți să rătășiți pe aici. Hai, thank you. Mm-hmm. Some minutes and include, but in the future, please be in time. Is the better open, and if you need, you can go and something do, but not disturb.
Doctor,
da.
Tell me when you call, because I'm with them, I will tell them to send request. Tell me when they can send. They are waiting.
Finish the discussion after, if will be the problem, we discussing about
situation. So what to tell them, to wait or...
I accepted.
Wait.
I accepted. All is okay.
Good.
Yeah, okay.
Da. I told you, wait some minutes, because colleague accept. That is very good manifested volume effects, especially for 70, for both, but for 70 more. And you can see why, because this depends by the pharmacokinetics of these drugs. Hypertensive effects the same, because increased preload, cardiac output, and blood pressure. It's very positive moments in hypotension, is very dangerous in cardiac failure. Therefore, it's necessary to think about this when you can use in which situation you can. Antithrombotic effects is the same, is very good, is the same, is the it's clear is the better for dextran 40 than for 470, but for both is. And the diuretic circulating blood volume, the same intensify renal flow, and this increase, improve glomerular filtration. But detoxication effects, if relatively weak, why? Because he can dilutions, but not improve elimination, not bind the toxins. Therefore, all these effects depends by the elimination of colloids and together with colloids and toxic toxins. Here you can see pharmacokinetics of dextran 1470, which is difference between these two drugs. You can read this material, but I need to show you the more important moment. For dextran 40, da, half life is 8 to 12 hours, approximately 70-80% of drugs eliminate in the first 24 hours. Dextran 70, da, approximately remain not 20%, da, but remain more, approximately 40% in the first day. And he eliminate every day, step by step, approximately in 5-7 days. Therefore, if compare these drugs and you have renal failure, it's clear is better use dextran 40 and less dextran 70 because he keep more time in body. Indications you can see here, treatment and prophylaxis of hypovolemic shock, all type of hypovolemic depends by the hemorrhage or trauma or convulsional or septic or other type. The same disease which disturb microcirculation is necessary to improve, prevent and treatment different type of thrombosis, because later we study hemostasis and you can see antithrombotic drugs, including classifications and colloids, especially 40, less 70 colloids. And therefore can use in prevent and treat thrombosis, thromboembolism, and renal disease and arteritis and other situation. And it's clear the treatment of poisoning use origin, but mechanism, I repeat, is only elimination, not bind, but elimination from body. Therefore, in acid intoxications, in base intoxications, can use per day in 24 hours, can be 20 liter, da, and can be more. Some source wrote about 40 liters per day, per 24 hours, to be more correct. And in acute hypotension, the same use. Side effects of this colloids, it's allergic reaction can be from pruritus till anaphylactic shock. And I explain why, because this is polysaccharides. And it's clear not all people suffer, can use different foods, different parts and of food And they are for substances, chemical or alimentary or other type. And here, this is the origin of an allergic reaction. And some country, if it's not acute situation, was some years ago, opinion before administration make the proba, like example, today make the proba, and after from these bottles use to administration. But it's clear in acute situation, this is not a good variant because you need today administrate this solution, not tomorrow. And therefore use without the proba, and therefore we have allergic reaction. About the pulmonary edema, especially if we had the heart failure, and it's clear in large volume can contribute to the acidosis, especially for dextran 40. Contraindications. Heart failure, it's clear. Renal failure, especially if it's oliguria or anuria, because these drugs can't eliminate it from body, therefore is contraindicated in cardiac failure, in renal failure, sorry. The same is necessary to be very attentive in cerebral trauma, which can develop cerebral edema, hemorrhagic stroke, or other situation, thrombocytopenia or diathesis or other disease, one can be potential bleeding effects, да, antithrombotic effects and be bleeding. And allergic reaction, if in the past was this problem, not can or try avoid this drug. What is important to know? Notabene here is dextrans is not recommended to associate with different drugs together in the one bottles in infusion. Therefore, if you need to introduce catecholamines, insulins, antibiotics, hydrocortisone and other drugs, here is more drugs, it's necessary to dissolve in sodium chloride solution or in glucose, but not together with dextrans. And now about the low molecular weight, like example, neopolivedon, neohemodes, neocompensanda, neo show about the low molecular weight. What is the effect? Detoxication effects is the more marked, like dextran 40 and 70. I told before. Why? Because this is not only eliminated like for 40 and 70, but dextran absorbed of toxins, and when eliminate from body, да, they bind these toxins, not only because it's increased diuresis, but because he bind the toxins and eliminate. Marked diuretic effect is the same for neopolivedon, neocompensan, for low molecular weight, but is not very good and is not compare with the dextran 40 and 70, restores of circulating blood volume, hypertensive effects, and antithrombotic effects. Viscosity not influence like 40 dextrans, да? And not restore like 70. And hypertensive effects not it's equal like for both these. Therefore, it depends by the situation or you combine different molecular weight or you use what is more necessary in this situation. He rapidly go to the body, not keep this low molecular weight, but use especially when we have intoxications. You can see here poisoning, all type of poisoning, or in peritonitis, postoperative, gastrointestinal infection, toxemia, can be hemolytic disease of newborns, and the same which in pregnancy toxicosis can use. Other you can see is less manifest effects. Therefore, it's not the most important to use for this aim. For this is important. Yeah? For this, you can combine, but more often use 1470. And to avoid the disadvantages for both group, in all country is recommended association or combination of colloids and crystalloids in a ratio 1:1, one part of colloids, one part of crystalloids. This is ideal association or combination, but depends by the country. In poor country, use one of colloids and two crystalloids. One colloids and three crystalloids. Maximal can be four parts crystalloids and one colloid. But in some source, is very poor country, use an ratio or one colloid and eight crystalloids. It's less physiological. It's necessary to keep 1:1 or 1:2, maximal four. The same is necessary when you use colloids and crystalloids and you introduce in body, is necessary to remember about elimination of this solution. How much you introduce to recover, this is one, but if you use big doses, big amount of solution, like for intoxications or in intoxications, is necessary to eliminate all this solution. Therefore, for each 1/2 liter eliminate the liquid, is necessary to use the 40 and 80 milligrams furosemide. It's from until, but can be a different sensibility, and the need the same can be different. And the same for each 1.5 liter is necessary to remember about restoration the important ions. So like potassium, like calcium, like magnesium, that is clear. I introduce 1.5 liter, is necessary to recover 10 milliliters of calcium, 10%, 10 milliliters magnesium, the same 10 milliliters potassium, to not have the problem, because you introduce, eliminate by force diuretics, and it's clear you eliminate all these ions from the body. Appear complications like hypo ions. And now I speak about the diuretics. Classifications according to the place of action you study in the said year is necessary only to repeat. According to the mechanism of action you repeat, because you have. In a clinic, importance is the latency period and duration of action of drugs, influence on acidobasic states, potassium elimination or not, but the same, it's necessary to know about the calcium elimination. We have the problem with patient with osteoporosis, hypocalcemia, is necessary to know which drug you can use, but which is necessary avoid, and the same concentration of uric acid in blood. And not forget about the patient with gouta. Yeah? And now we speak about the clinical importance, latency and duration of action. You can see here three groups. Short latency, this is till 1 hour latency, and duration of action can be maximal 8 hours, not more. And this is characteristic for osmotic diuretics and for loop diuretics. you can see anthracycline, anthracycline, endocrinone, and other drugs. Middle action, latency is till 3 hours. Duration can be between 8 till 24 hours. Depends by the diuretic, depends by the body. And this middle action, middle latency, middle duration include thiazides, tetrachlorothiazides, cyclopentiazides, another type thiazides, like thiazides, clopamide, indapamide, xipamide, and other drugs. And non-competitive aldosterone antagonists like triamcinolone, amiloride, carbon anhydrase inhibitors like acetazolamide, sulfiam, metazolamide, and other drugs. What includes slow latency? Slow latency can be from 2 to 3 days latency. That will be patient when the drugs start action after 2-3 days. It's necessary to understand this moment. And duration the same will be from 2 till 7. That you finish the treatment but continue the duration of action and activity of this drug. What to include here? If you see thiazides wall is in middle action, but exception of thiazides, this is the only polythiazide. And exception for like thiazides, all like thiazides is middle action. But only chlortalidone, this is an exception from this group, manifest slow latency and long period of action. And competitive aldosterone antagonist, like spironolactone, eplerenone, the same long period of action. That's non-competitive is middle, competitive is long. The next importance is according to the potency of action, force diuresis, he can eliminate till 35% of sodium. This include osmotic diuretics and loop diuretics. Diuretics with middle intensity till maximal eliminate 10% of sodium. It's clear and possibility to eliminate liquid. That will be the same late, but it's middle. Thiazides like thiazides and carbohydrate inhibitors. And the small intensity, this is this aldosterone antagonist competitive and non-competitive all together. And the same, the drugs which not manifest specific effects. Delayed arteria and increase diuretics, diuresis, like example, cardiac glycosides, today's study, methylxanthines and vasodilators. Arterial vasodilators is clear. According to the influence on acidobasic states, diuretics that caused marked acidosis. This include carbohydrate inhibitors. The second group, diuretics that produce moderate metabolic acidosis, but with one condition, long period of administration and in high doses. If you use low doses, but long period, not manifest this metabolic acidosis. But if you use high doses and long period, can manifest acidosis. This is both antagonist, aldosterone antagonist drugs, competitive, non-competitive. And the next group, which can produce the opposite, moderate metabolic alkalosis with the same conditions, long administration, period of administration, and in high doses. And this is his characteristic for loop diuretics. According to the elimination of potassium, you can see ratio, the correlation between diuresis and caliuresis 1:1. What does it mean? Andiuresis is high, in caliuresis is high. This is this characteristic for thiazides, like thiazides and carbohydrate inhibitors. The same is high calcium uretics effects because diuresis is, if he, is 1 and calureses is 75%, da? Deci is the same high. It's not a big difference between this group, loop diuretics, and the leucaliuretics drugs, da? This is, will be osmotic diuretics and cardiac glycosides, methyl xanthine and vasodilators. Here we not speak about the drugs which keep it clear, but which eliminate potassium. You, we can see very high potency, da, elimination of potassium, and low, which is more less dangerous. According to the elimination of potassium, you can see here two groups. The first classification is diuretic that increase calcium excretion, and therefore increase blood calcium level. He keep calcium, especially if we have osteoporosis. It's clear it will be good this group, like thiazides and thiazides and like thiazides drugs. Diuretics. And the next group, diuretics that decrease calcium excretion, da? Why is, sorry, increase calcium excretion? Why is importance? Because how you have a situation with osteoporosis, the same can be rarely than osteoporosis, but can be hypercalcemia. And in this situation, it will be better use this group, like loop diuretics, like osmotic diuretics, and carbohydrates inhibitors. this story must be increase potassium excretion is a mistake, sorry. According to the influence on uric acid concentration, the same, the patient who have the problem with gouta, with podagra, which have high concentration of uric acid, da, it's necessary to avoid following diuretics, not use. Da? Like loop diuretics, like thiazides and carbohydrate inhibitors. If the patient have this problem, is the better use the drugs which not influence this and not worse situation with patient. What you can use? Osmotic and antagonist of aldosterone antagonist, or competitive or non-competitive, not depend. And now here is diuretics like antihypertensive. He is not show like antihypertensive. Da? More often use thiazides because tomorrow is topic. Thiazides like thiazides for long period of treatment. Da? Can be in potassium keeping or sparing. Da? And for acute situation use or in crisis, use loop diuretics. How work diuretics like antihypertensive? All people remember about the diuretic effects and forget about the other important mechanism, like decrease calcium influx, iron influx in small muscle, especially in veins, and diminish arterial pressure after 10 minutes of administration due to this mechanism of action. And this, da? The same will be and the elimination of liquid, da? But this is appear after 30 minutes. If you introduce intravenously of intravenously administration of furosemide, like example, effects appear after 10 minutes. But it's clear in 10 minutes he can't be in urine. Therefore, it's clear this first of all work like vasodilators, and only after, later, he work and like diuretics. when in using like antihypertensive drugs, they can be like the drugs for the first line of administration, especially in older people. Like monotherapy can be in easy form, especially if it's edema or other situation. Is obligatory components in combination with other drugs. In emergency, use loop diuretics or drugs with very short latency period. Да? Especially in fat person, hypertension in fat person with hyperaldosteronism, especially use the drugs which diminish antagonist of spironolactone. And the mechanism of action, which is important to understand, that it's clear if you use like monotherapy, tomorrow you you speak about other drugs when you use like monotherapy, we need the second and the third step when you add other drugs. But now we speak only about diuretics because he is mechanism of action. And it's clear because diminish the water volume, blood volume diminish, the diuretic effects manifest diminish an arterial pressure. And how diminish arterial pressure? Body start recover what he lose. What lose arterial pressure, he lose. Therefore, he include drugs include renin releasing, and it's clear arterial pressure try to increase. Therefore, the second step of administration, if you start with diuretic, is necessary something, да, some drugs, but that can interrupt this mechanism of action. And he, you can see here alpha adrenomimetics with central action, beta adrenoblockers, or the drugs which influence system renin, angiotensin, aldosterone. And the clinical importance is tolerance to diuretic. What does it mean, tolerance? Ineffectiveness. Sometimes was effective and after developing different situations or in heart failure progression or especially in renal or if we combine these two renal and heart failure, да, not work like before these diuretics. Tolerance can be earlier, here you can see earlier, and can be later. Why appear early and won't appear? If you start treatment, and like example, da, 1 week or 2 week was very good effect, then after this develop the tolerance, not work. These drugs not manifest diuretic effects. Why? This is depends by the neurotransmitters activation. Or angiotensin, or aldosterone, catecholamines, vasopressin, another can be. And what is necessary to do? Is recommended in the second columns, is recommendation. What is necessary to do? Use very small doses, if you're not necessary to use angiotensin converting enzyme, like drugs, is not necessary. But appear tolerance, да, tolerance is necessary to prevent or to eliminate this tolerance if you use very low doses of angiotensin converting enzyme. If we speak about the late refractory effects or tolerance, this can be after some months of administration the drugs. But now activity can be, because some patients have cardiac failure which need use all the time. Arterial hypertension and other drugs which disease can be. Why you develop this tolerance? This is caused by the hypertrophy of epithelial cells, like response to the increased reabsorption of electrolytes. What is necessary to do is here. Can be different variant to help this situation. First of all, it's necessary to limit salt administration, not liquid, salt. If you diminish salts, liquid not clean body. This is clear. It's necessary to correct speak about this moment. The next, you can use intravenously administration. Like example, till now he used internal and was effective, but now not. We can use intravenously rapidly and after put infusion, because if you be attentive and read the literature about the diuretics, about the loop diuretics like furosemide, like torsemide, about furosemide, more often used in acute situation, that can use very high doses, depends by the situation. And the same, what does it mean, high doses of furosemide? Source show about the 600 milligrams, about the 1,000 milligrams, that can be very big, depends by the situation. And the same sometimes is necessary to normalize the blood pressure. Depends by the same situation. Or you use dopamine infusion, or can use not use vasodilators, or is necessary to improve elimination if you use prednisolone or glucocorticoid something. The same is necessary to normalize the neurohormonal profile if you prescribe ACE inhibitors or spironolactone or other drugs. And sometimes can be not enough protein level and therefore not work because these diuretics need bind with the protein plasma, plasma protein. And if it's not enough, it's necessary to recover, to work the drug. And not only diuretics, another drug the same. And the same, sometimes is necessary to improve heart work if use positive inotropic drugs. And the last variant that can be combined different diuretics or diuretics with different mechanism of action, different place of action. All this aim will be potential effects. Therefore, only in this situation, when you have tolerance, you can use or combine different two or three diuretics drugs. Interaction of diuretics with other drugs is necessarily the same. Remember, this problem is all time necessary. Remember, because very often patients take acetylic acid drugs who not receive after 50 years, old people not use acetylic acid. Practical all. Not depends how the name, which the name use, cardiomagnil or acetylic acid or aspirin, is not important, is acetylic acid. But together, it's clear diminished diuretic effects. This is moment which you include acetylic acid because it's competitions for tubular transport. Who from the patients world not use anti-inflammatory non-steroidal? Problem is more than necessary. The same diminished diuretic effects is necessary to remember because in this situation these drugs not work like till now, it's necessary to change the doses. If you speak about the treatment diuretics together with glycosides, that is very good to diminish cardiac failure, to improve the situation. But in the same time, one increase the effectiveness if use these two groups in cardiac failure. In the same time, increase in hypokalemia, because both contribute to the diminished potassium in blood. Not depends if it's diazides or furosemide, not depends, that, but produce hypokalemia. Some drugs like barbiturates, like benzodiazepines, like other drugs, influence diuretic effects can diminish because they induce liver enzyme and metabolize these drugs very quickly. Therefore, it's necessary something to do. Or use this more often, or change the drugs, not influence. Да? Or use big doses. It's necessary something to change. For today is all. If appear the questions, please, I listen and I answer. If not, I tell you goodbye. And good luck. Do you have any questions? No. Student, you are hearing me or not? Good. Goodbye and good luck, students.
Thank you, doctor. Have a nice day.
Have a nice day.